Good morning, children. Today we are going to see Standard 12 Business Mathematics Chapter 2 Integral Calculus Exercise 2.10. In this exercise, we are going to see the gamma integral. What is the formula? Gamma integral. If n is a positive integer, means we have to apply this formula. 0 to infinity, the limit will be 0 to infinity. X power of n e power of minus ax dx equal to n factorial divided by a power of n plus n. Some properties are using here. So listen here, gamma n equal to n minus 1 gamma n minus 1 n greater than 1. N will be the greater than 1. So this property, some of you are using this one. So second, gamma n plus 1 equal to n into gamma n greater than 0 means we have to apply this property. So gamma n plus 1 equal to n factorial, n is a positive integer means you have to apply this one, n factorial. So finally the property is the gamma 1 by 2 equal to, you have to substitute like this, root pi. So this property, this fourth property of this one, n is a positive, we are going to apply the into the exercise sums. Let's see the exercise sums. How to apply this property into exercise sums. Okay. Let's see the first question. What is the question given in the exercise 2.10? So evaluate the following. Gamma 4. What is the question given here? Gamma 4. So what is the procedure we are going to find out here? So simple one. This one is a positive integer. Now just we have to apply this one. Gamma 4. You have to apply this one. N minus 1 is a formula. What is the formula here? N minus 1 is a formula. N minus 1 factorial. N minus 1 factorial. What is the n value? 4 minus 1 factorial. You are getting 3 factorial. What is 3 factorial? You have to write like this. Factorial is 3 into 2 into 1. What is the factorial meaning? 3 into 2 into 1. Equal to what is the answer getting here? That will be 6. Okay, 3 2s are 6. That's all. So it is simplest one only. So let's see the second one. So what is the question given here? So let's see. The second one looks like a fraction form. It looks like a fraction form. Gamma into 9 by 2. So this one is a question. Gamma into 9 by 2. You have to write like this. What is the property, sir? Take care. Let's see the property. So here we are giving gamma 9 by 2. It is in a fraction. This value will be greater than 1. This value will be greater than 1. N will be the greater than 1 means you have to apply this formula. So listen here. So what is the formula we are going to apply here? 7. So 9 divided by 2 minus 1. That will be, formula will be N minus 1. That will be, you have to write like this. N. So then gamma. Then here N minus 1 is a formula. So what is the formula here? Let's write the formula first. N minus 1 gamma N minus 1. What is the formula here? N minus 1 gamma N minus 1. Now I am going to apply this. What is the N value here? 9 by 2 minus 1 gamma 9 by 2 minus 1. So then we are going to apply this one. So it will be goes this side. 2 will be multiplied into 1. You are getting 9 minus 2. That will be 7 divided by 2. Gamma. Here that will be 7 divided by 2. Again here gamma you are having means 7 by 2 will be remains constant here. Again you have to solve the same procedure. So here you have to apply this one. 7 by 2 minus 1 gamma 7 by 2 minus 1. So same procedure you have to follow here. So here 7 by 2. Here you are getting 2 into 1, that will be, you are getting, that is 5 by 2 gamma, here itself 5 by 2. So next step you are going to apply this one. Same procedure you have to follow here. So listen, next step, this one 7 by 2 and 5 by 2 is my common here. Here you are getting 5 by 2 minus 1. 5 by 2 minus 1. So then, so what is the formula here? 5 by 2 minus 1 gamma. 5 by 2 minus 1. Here you are getting 7 by 2, 5 by 2, then 5 by 2 will be goes this side, that will be, you are getting 3 by 2 gamma. Here itself 3 by 2. So here gamma of 3 by 2, you are writing like the same procedure. So again I am going to take this one. So 3 by 2 minus 1, 3 by 2 minus 1, gamma of 3 by 2 minus 1. So then we are getting 7 by 2, 5 by 2, 3 by 2, here 2 will be goes as minus, that will be 1 by 2, here you are gamma 1 by 2. So we know the, let's see the property here. What is the property? Gamma 1 by 2 value, that will be root pi. So what is the value? 7 by 2 here into 5 by 2 into 3 by 2, 1 by 2, gamma 1 by 2 value, that will be root pi. What is the value? What is the property as given here? Gamma 1 by 2, that will be root pi. So you are right like this. Here 7 pi is 35, 35 into 3, that will be 105. 105 divided by 2 2s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 8 2s are 16. So 16 into root 5, that's all. So we are using this formula. Okay. So here given the formula means n greater than 1 means we are using this formula. So listen, what is the third question given here? So understood children, it will be easiest one only. Okay, let's see the third question. What is the question given here? Integrate of integrate of 0 to infinity, what is the limit here? 0 to infinity, e power of minus mx, e power of minus mx, x power of 6 dx. So what is the question? Integrate of 0 to infinity, e power of minus mx, x power of 6 dx. So what is the condition question given here? That gamma is 0 to infinity, x power of n, e power of minus ax. I am applying this formula here. So now we have what is the formula? That will be n factorial divided by a power of n plus 1. What is the formula? 0 to infinity, integrate of 0 to infinity, x power of n, e power of minus ax, dx equal to n factorial divided by a power of n plus 1. So now I am going to have, so this one is x power, and what is the power value here? That will be 6. That will be after writing the n equal to 6. What is the a value here? So here we are having a value, here itself we are having a, that will be a is equal to m. So what is the value given data here? So now I am going to apply here 0 infinity x power of 6 e power of minus mx dx equal to, you have to write like this, use this factorial format. What is the n value? That will be 6 factorial divided by m power of 6 plus 1. Now we are getting 6 factorial divided by m power of 7. Okay, let's see the next question. So easy. Only you have to study the property. The next sum, that will be same procedure you are going to use. What is the question given here? Fourth one. Integrate of 0 to infinity e power of minus 4x, x power of 4 dx. This in this sum also we are going to be using the same formula here. So listen here. So what is the formula? 0 to infinity x power of n e power of minus ax dx equal to n factorial divided by a plus n plus 1. So same formula we are going to apply here. So what is the given data? What is the n value? That will be n is equal to 4, a is equal to 4. So here, listen here, one confusion will be came here. So what is the, here itself we are having minus. Here itself we have, we don't take the sign here because minus minus will be cancelled. What is the value for A? Just take this one. What is the value for A only? Don't take the sign. Okay. So let's substitute this one. So integrate of 0 to infinity x power of 4 e power of minus 4x dx equal to, what is the n factorial, n value, that will be 4 factorial divided by, what is the 4 power of 4 plus 1, that you are getting 4 factorial divided by 4 power of 5. So here you are going to write like this, 4 factorial you are writing like this, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1, here for power 4 will be 4 into 4, then you have to cancel this 4, then 2, 2 2's are then 4. What is the value, remaining values here? 3 divided by 2 4's are 8, 8 4's are 32 into 4 will be 32 into 4, 128. What's the value here? 128. So getting 3 divided by 128 is the answer for this question. So let's see the fifth one. So what is the fifth one given here? It's also using same formula. I'm going to use this one. Let's see simple procedure here. So what is the question given? 0 to infinity, integrate of 0 to infinity, e power of minus x by 2, e power of minus x by 2, x power of 5 dx. Here itself, little bit confusion will be came here, because here we are going to take this one. What is the given data here? So same formula we are going to use in. So n value that will be 5, n value that will be 5, a value equal to that will be 1 by 2. So now I am going to substitute into the formula. 0 to infinity x power of 5 e power of x by 2 dx equal to, now I am going to write here, what is the n value here? That will be 5 divided by 1 by 2 power of 5 plus 1. 1 by 2 power of 5 plus 1. Now we have to write like 5 divided by 1 by 2 power of 6. 1 by 2 power of 6. You have to write like this. 5 divided by 1 by 1 power of 6, 2 power of 6. 1 will be reciprocate, means it will be go into numerator. You have to write like this. 2 power of 6 into 5. 2 power of 7. You have to abbreviate this one. It will be correct. If you are stopping from this method, this step, it is also correct. Okay, given full marks to you. Okay. So next let's see the, here we have the factorial will be missing here. Factorial will be missing here. So what's the second one here? So the second one, f of x function. They're given in the function format. So question given in the function format. If f of x equal to x square e power of 2x, e power of 2x, x greater than or equal to 0, greater than or equal to 0, if it will be 0 means otherwise, 0 means otherwise, so then evaluate the 0 to infinity f of x dx, then evaluate 0 to infinity f of x dx. F of x dx. What is the function given here? After writing like 0 to infinity, what is the f of x value? That will be x square e power of minus 2x dx. So f of x value, x square e power of minus 2x dx. I am going to take this one, n is equal to, that will be 2, a is equal to minus 2. What is the formula here? 0 to infinity x power of n e power of minus ax dx equal to n factorial divided by a power of n plus 1. Now we are going to apply this here. So what is the value getting here for? Equal to, what is the n value? 2 factorial divided by, what is the a value? No need to take this sign here. No need to take sign here. Just you have to take the value only. Okay. So here we are going to 2 factorial divided by 2 power of 2 plus 1. 2 power of 2 plus 1 means 2 factorial divided by 2 power of 3. So 2 factorial means 2 divided by 2 power of 3. You have to cancel this one. What is the value? 1 divided by 2 square, that will be 4. So that's all the answer for this one. Okay children, today we completed exercise 2.10. The next class we are going to see the 2.11. It will be very important exercise. Definite integral is the limit of the sum. Next class we are going to see the 2.11. Okay. Thank you children. Let's see the next class.